Question number four, the Honourable Annette King.
Tēnā koe, Mr Speaker. My question is to the Minister of Health. When was he or his office first briefed on the contents of the draft New Zealand Health Strategy?
The Honourable Dr Jonathan Coleman.
Kia ora, Mr Speaker. Last November, I asked officials to commence work on refreshing the New Zealand Health Strategy, which had not been updated since the year 2000. Since that time, I've met regularly with officials to discuss the direction of the strategy. Following extensive engagement and input from a wide range of stakeholders, I received the first written draft of the strategy on the 3rd of July.
Supplementary question,
the
Mr.
The Honourable Annette King, supplementary question.
In light of that answer, when he decided to update the New Zealand Health Strategy, did he have any discussions with the Director General of Health on what needed to be reviewed, including funding and governance arrangements for DHBs?
The Honourable Dr Jonathan Coleman.
Mr Speaker, I talked to the Director General about a wide range of subjects, and of course funding, you know, going into the first budget of Health Minister is going to form a core part of those discussions. What else would one expect?
Supplementary question.
Supplementary question, the Honourable Annette King.
How could he be unaware of proposed changes to DHB structures and funding when his Director General of Health, not a third party as he claimed, had one, been briefing him on progress since the beginning of the month, and secondly, DHB chairs and CEOs had been given the recommendations in the leaked reports 2 weeks ago?
Mr Speaker,
the member is confusing three different reviews there. Now, basically, the funding review and the stolen capacity and capability review are reviews commissioned by the Director General of Health. So they're his reviews. He receives the recommendations. He was about to brief me. And then, of course, the report was stolen by Mrs King's contact.
Point of order, Mr Speaker.
Point of order, Mr Speaker.
I take exception to the last remark that the member made. I have no contact that stole any documents.
Order. 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 I get order. The way forward is to settle the House. I'm going to ask the minister just to withdraw that remark. But personally, I didn't think it was anywhere a reflection on the member herself. But could I ask? Order. Could I ask the minister simply to withdraw that part about a stolen paper?
Well, Mr Speaker,
order, no,
okay, I withdraw.
Thank you. Supplementary question, the Honourable Annette King.
If he is now ruling out any changes to DHB governance arrangements, why did he allow papers to go out with proposed changes he didn't agree with, said he hadn't read the review report, and then blamed the Director General of Health calling him a third party? I mean, is that incompetence or laziness?
No.
The Honourable Dr Jonathan
Coleman. That's completely incorrect. The Director General wasn't called a third party. If you want to know what incompetence and laziness is, it's a minister who doubles the budget and does 2,000 fewer operations, who culls 30,000 patients from waiting lists and sends 760 people to Australia for cancer treatment, and that minister was Annette King.
Yes.
Supplementary question, the Honourable.
That's not going to save him either. Supplementary question.
Supplementary question, the Honourable.
Is he now taking a whole of government approach to sensitive issues by getting the communications manager from the National Cyber Intelligence Office of GCSB to issue rebuttal lines to the media for his Director General of Health? Neither are the minister nor the CEO capable of fronting difficult issues?
Well,
Honourable Dr.
Well, obviously that's a ridiculous statement. What I am focusing on is repairing the damage done by Annette King's $150 million DHB deficit that she left behind, and we've now got down to about 50.
Point of order.
Order.
Point of order.
Order. Point of order, the Honourable Annie.
Thank you, Mr Speaker. I seek leave to table an email from Cherie Blythe from DPMC at the National Cyber Intelligence Office, who sent the email to Radio New Zealand on behalf of the Director General of Health.
I just need the date of it. Leave us to table that particular email dated yesterday. Is there any objection? There is none. It can be tabled.
Thank you, Mr Speaker.
Question. Order. Order. Question number five.